here we have a supine patient. We tell the patient to turn the head towards one side and we expose all the anterior lateral neck. From the mastoid process, that is what I'm showing you at the moment, we find the beginning of the SCOM muscle, which is sternocleidomastoid muscle. With the finger, with the index, I'm following all the muscle. This is the sternal part of the SCOM, that is the part that goes all the way down to the sternum. During a contraction, the muscle comes out and we can see that the tendon goes all the way down to the sternum. I ask the patient to lift the head a little bit. It is a light movement is enough to show it. Let's now see the treatment of the SCOM muscle as well as the scalene muscles. The patient is supine. We ask the patient to make a flexion, a very gentle flexion to locate the SCOM. As we saw before, the palpatory anatomy is quite visible. Then we use a pinch grip. And with the pinch grip, we grab the SCOM. It has to be comfortable, it doesn't need to be painful, even if this technique is always a little bit annoying and unpleasant. When with the pinch grip, we have palpated the neck in order to find the trigger points and then the taut bend. We will do the pinch grip to do this ischemic compression. Of course, we would have no possibility to push against anything hard. That's why we need to do this ischemic compression with the pinch grip. It is a quite long muscle, so we can decide where to work and where to palpate depending on where the taut bend is. This ischemic compression can be held for several seconds, can be 30, 60, 90 seconds maximum. A reduction of the symptoms gives us a positive feedback of releasing a trigger point.
Thanks for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, like the video, and leave your comments below. Your feedback is crucial for us. Be sure to also watch the video on treating sciatica and lumbago. You can watch them by clicking on the side thumbnails. Also, take a look at the link in the description to explore our courses and keep enhancing your knowledge and skills. See you in the next video.